Hey folks, just thought I'd show you something right here. We're off the coast of let's see, Newfoundland and Labrador. And if you can see right here, some harp waves right there. And you can see they're probably stemming from somewhere offshore, I'm assuming. It's like a little island right here. But I want you to see these trails in the sky, and you can actually see the shadows in the water of the trails, which is really interesting. Where's that shadow? There's one here that's particularly large, and there's a huge shadow attached. But anyway, you can go look for yourself, and that's a worldview. I thought I'd bring it to your attention, give you something worth looking at. Look at this strange collection of moisture right there at the corner. And what happens is there's a couple harp places right around Massachusetts. MIT has something over there. See over this island right here, Gulf of St. Lawrence. There's some stuff happening right there. You can just look around and you'll find this. And actually, you know, it's almost make a game out of this to see how many anomalies you can actually find. And you can actually look at some of the if you go to Google Maps, you can just type in harp locations, and you'll get all the actual data for harp locations. I just thought I'd show you that Florida's being blasted right now, and we're basically like the past few days. The waves have been so strong here, it's been ridiculous. Really, you can feel it. You can feel it. Look at this right here. See that? You can feel this. There's no mistaking it. It's not something you're going to get used to. It's pretty disturbing. I don't really, I'm very, very highly, what you call it, sensitive to EMFs and stuff like that. Like you're sitting next to speakers and stuff, or any kind of electrical outlets that are emitting high EMFs really cause me some issues, and this really causes me some pretty bad issues when they turn on that harp machine. See the shadow right there? Yeah, look at that line. What is that? A mistake? No, no mistake. They're not drawing on here. But go ahead and have yourself some fun, NASA Worldview. The NASA Worldview. I'm gonna keep this video short because I don't. Whoa, look at that one. I don't want to really be doing this all night, first of all, and second of all, I'd rather you guys just check it out for yourself. It's kind of a trip, man, to see how many of these trails you can find, and all the harp waves you can spot, and find out where they are, and see the places where you're actually being emitted from. And look at that. Look what they're doing to them in Europe, Bay of Fundy. I'm sorry, that's not Europe. That's the Gulf of Maine. My bad. Nova Scotia. Yeah, that's Europe. Yeah, basically, it's Europe. Nova Scotia. Anyway, well, have a nice evening. I'll talk to you guys later, and be well, be safe, and be vigilant, be alert about what's happening to your world right now. It's pretty devastating stuff. And check out here Africa, where all those where all the dryness is. You see what's happening offshore here. You can learn some real good things. Also, look up your hurricanes. Find out what happened around your hurricanes. You can see all the harp waves there, kind of messed up. NASA Worldview, you could add layers. You can go down here, check out your layers. You go down here to add layers, and you can have tons of stuff. Tons of fun. Tons of fun. Learn a lot about the Earth and what they're doing to it with geoengineering and weather modification. Peace, guys. Have a good night. This is Frank out. Have a good night. Peace.